Okay, so we're going to go over Sterling's command and show you how you can stay consistent with him once he goes home. So you want to be sure to have fun with him, but you also want to be sure to be firm and consistent with his rewards and corrections. So if he needs a reward, make sure to reward him. If he does something that you like, if he does something good, you want to be sure to reward that. But then if he does an unwanted behavior, if he gets too excited and he jumps maybe, then you want to be sure to correct that and be firm with that. That way he knows that he's not supposed to be doing that. So his first command is heel. This is loose leash walking on the left hand side. You want to be sure that he's right there next to you, but you also want to be sure that your arms and your leash are nice and relaxed. You want to make sure that there's no tension on his collars. That way he knows again that he's doing the right thing. So you want to be sure that your arms are nice and relaxed, that leash is nice and relaxed, he's in that heel position on the left hand side, and then you can reward that. So if he's right there next to you where you want him to be, you can reward that. If he looks up at you and shows you, oh hey, I'm paying attention, you can reward that. Anything that you like, you can reward. So you want to be sure to reward that. But if he were to get too far ahead of you, then we're going to show you later on in the video how you would correct that behavior. So that is heel or loose leash walking on the left hand side. His next command is a sit stay. So you'll tell Sterling to sit, have him sit, and then you can reward him for sitting. And then if you want him to stay there, you'll remind him sit. We don't say stay just because it's one more word for him to remember. So you're going to say sit. And then if you want to go put your shoes on or put your coat on before your walk, you can remind him sit and then step away from him. Then you want to go back to him. Good sit, good boy, good job. And then you can reward that behavior again if he stays. Correct it if he were to get up. But if he stays, you want to go all the way back to him. Good sit, good job. You can reward him. Make sure he's still in that sit position. And then when you're ready, you can free or heel him, whatever you want him to do next. So that is sit stay. Again, the stay is implied. So you just remind him sit when you walked away. Go back to him to reward and release him. His next command is a down stay. So you want to tell Sterling down. He may need some help just because he still has that puppy brain and he's kind of clumsy sometimes. So you just say down. Sometimes he may need help with the leash to know that he's supposed to go down. But once he's in that down, good job. You can reward that behavior. And then if you wanted him to stay again while you put your shoes or your coat on, you would just remind him down before walking away. Then once you're ready to go back to him, you would go all the way back to him. Good down, good job, good boy, whatever you want to say to him. But you would go back to him, reward him for that behavior, and then you could release him by saying free or heel, again, whatever you wanted him to do next. So you would tell him down, remind him down before you walked away, go back, reward, good job, good down. You want to reward those treats down next to the ground. That way he knows that his head's supposed to be down, so he's still in that down. And then when you're ready, you can free or heel him. So that is his down stay. His next command is come when called. So he is out in the yard running around, anything like that, sniffing, playing in the snow, and then you're ready for him to come back to you. So you would say come. You want to make sure that you're loud and firm with it. That way he hears you and understands the command. So you would say come. Then Sterling's supposed to turn his head around and come running back towards you. You want to make sure to be fun and exciting with this command. That way he knows that you're more exciting than what he was just playing with out in that yard. Again, he still has that puppy brain, so he's easily distracted. So you want to make sure to be fun, exciting, get his attention. You would say come, nice, loud, firm command. Then you want to take a few steps backwards. That way he knows that it's you who's calling him and you welcome him into our space. We don't want to go towards Sterling because then Sterling's going to think that it's a game or that he's getting chased. So you would say come. And then when he's coming back toward you, you can do verbal praise. Good job, good boy, good job. Then he gets back to you, he sits down, then you can reward that behavior. So I always like to give Sterling a target for his nose to go to, just especially since he is still a pup. We want to be sure to give him that target. That way he's less likely to jump, because if he's coming back towards you and you're being exciting, he's also going to get excited. So if we give him a target with our hand, he's more likely to put his nose to where that target is. So you would say come, take those few steps backwards, and then I like to put my hand on my thigh to give him that target to run to. So then he's going to put his nose there, he sits down for you, and you can reward that. You want to make sure that you're always rewarding this command. This is the most important command to reward, because we want, again, to teach him that you're more exciting than what he was just playing with or sniffing in that yard. So come, he comes running back towards you, you give him that target to run to, then you can reward him when he's sitting. Then he's supposed to sit there until you release him. So you want to free him again so he can go run and play. Then you would say free. If you want to switch to a heel, you would say heel and have him heel with you. Sometimes during that transition, if you go from freeing him to healing, he might get a little confused, so he may need a reminder. Heel, this is what we're doing, buddy. But you would just say heel. Again, he may need that little reminder, but then once he knows what he's supposed to be doing, isn't confused anymore, he can go right into that heel from running around in the yard. So that is come when called. That is coming to you from point A to point B. He's in the yard and he comes running back towards you. And then again, you can either free him again back into the yard or you can have him heal with you. So that is come when called. His next command is place. This is a stay on an elevated boundary. So unlike the down stay or the sit stay, he's now on an elevated boundary like the bed. So you would say place, either send him to place or walk him to place, either one. Then once he's on place, you can reward him, but we always reward place on the bed. That way he thinks the treats come from the bed and he's more likely to stay on the bed. So you would say place, good place, and then same as the other stays, the stay is implied. So you would say place, remind him place before you walk away, and then you could go do what you needed to do, fix dinner, anything like that. So you would say place, remind him place before you walk away. And then we always want to be sure to go back to reward and go back to release our stay command. So same as the down stay and the sit stay, we want to go all the way back to Sterling. So we want to go back to that bed. Good job, good place, reward on the bed. And then if you're ready to release him, you can say free or heal him off the bed. But we want to make sure that you're back on or back next to that bed that he's on. That way he's more likely to stay on the bed. Because if we teach him that, oh, you free from a distance, then he's going to be more likely to get up when you walk in the room or when you get too far away from him, anything like that, because he's going to know that you have the treats. So we want to be sure to reward on the bed and release him from right next to him, not from a distance. So that is place stay. His next command is leave it. We want to be sure to practice leave it with dog safe foods first. So hot dogs, his treats, his food, anything like that that's safe for him to eat. That way, if you do accidentally drop a pill on the ground or you spill something else on the ground that he's not supposed to have, you have already practiced this enough that he knows he's not supposed to eat or drink what's on the ground. So you would drop that on the ground. The first couple times you want to practice this with his leash on until you know that he'll do it for you. So you would drop something on the ground, say leave it. If he goes towards it, you could pull him away. And then if he doesn't go after what's on the ground, you would reward that behavior. So drop something on the ground, leave it. Then he looks at you for that reward. So you reward him and then you can pick up whatever's on the ground. So that is leave it. Again, you want to practice leave it with dog safe foods first. That way he's prepared for a situation where it would be a pill or medicine or something that you spilled or dropped on the ground. So that is leave it. Those are Sterling's commands: heel, sit, stay, down, stay, come when called, place, and leave it. So those are Sterling's commands. And now we're going to shortly go over his collars. That way we know for when I bring him out. And then we're going to show you his commands. And then at the last 10 to 15 minutes of the video, we're going to go over his collars more in depth. I just don't want to throw too much information at you at once. So his collars, his first one is the prong collar. So this is going to sit on Sterling's neck like this. And then if Sterling were to pull too far ahead of you in a heel, you would say no, quick pop and release of this collar until he's back in your space. And then you could go back to having it relaxed. So again, it's a pop and release. We want to make sure that we're not leaving this as a triangle or keeping tension on that, because then he's going to get used to the collar and it's not going to work. So you want it nice and relaxed until you need it. Then you would say no, pop and release the collar, and then remind him what he's supposed to be doing. He's back in your space, nice and relaxed again. So that's the prong collar. To get this on and off of him, you're going to push these prongs together, pull them apart. So you'll pull them apart, then you'll put one side in the little hole and you're going to pinch them together until the other one fits and slide it down. Again, you want to pull them apart. So I usually use one finger to kind of push them up and then I pull it out. And then you put one side in, pinch them together, and it slides right in there. So that is the prong collar. Then for the remote collar, I've already turned it on. Let me turn it off really quick. So for the remote collar, on the collar, there is a small red button. This is a key or a magnet. And then on the remote, there is another small red key or magnet. So we're going to take these two and we're going to tap them together until we see that green light. Now the collar is turned on. It'll flash green every couple seconds to let you know that it's on. So now that the collar is on, we're going to turn the remote on as well. So on the back of the remote, there is a large L button in the center. You're going to press and hold that button until his screen lights up. now both the collar and the remote are on. Sorry, turn the flashlight on for a second. We'll go over that feature again at the end of the video. But now that the remote and the collar are both on, I'm gonna pretend that my hand is Sterling's neck. So Sterling is wearing his collar and he were walking too far ahead of you in a heel. We're gonna use the black S button to the side. And if, again, he's walking too far ahead of you in a heel, you're gonna say no, press the black S button and remind him that he's supposed to be heeling with you. So you would say no, press the black S button and remind him heel. So no, button, heel. Again, we want to remind him what he's supposed to be doing. We say the no to give him a warning that, hey, you're getting a correction. Then we use the button to correct him, and then we remind him what he's supposed to be doing. So he gets up from a sit, anything like that. We would say no, press the button, sit. No, button, down. Anything like that for all of his commands. So that is a short overview of the collars. Again, we'll go over them in further detail at the end. And now we're going to show you his commands.
Hey, there's a truck.
You're fine.
Thank you.
down. Down. Good down. Good boy. Down. Good down. Good boy. Down. Good down. Good boy. Good job. Good down. Down. Free. Good boy. Okay, so now that we've gone over Sterling's commands, showed you his commands, we're going to go over the remote collar and the prong collar more in depth. So just a reminder for the prong collar, sits on his neck like this. You want to be sure to give him a quick pop and release for that correction. And to get it on and off, push the collar or the prongs out, pull them apart. Then to get it back together, you'll put one side in, pinch them together, and slide it back in. So that's his prong collar. Again, you want to make sure this is nice and relaxed until you need that correction. Then it's a quick pop and release. So then for his remote collar, I've showed you how to turn it on. Tap these two together to turn it on. You'll see that green light flash. It'll flash green to show you that it's on and fully charged. If it starts to flash yellow or red, that just means that the collar needs to be charged. Then let me shut it off. To turn on the remote, you're going to press and hold the black L button in the center until the screen lights up. So now the remote and the collar are both turned on. Again, that black S button now is going to be his correction. So I have this as Sterling's neck. I'm going to say no, press the button heel, no button sit, no button down, anything like that. We want to be sure to correct him with that. Then, so that is his correction level. His correction level is at 20 right now. But the red S button is going to be his boost feature. This is going to be for emergencies only. I have not had to use this with Sterling. But say he, for some reason, gets out and he's running towards the road and there's a car and you need to get his attention right away. You're going to say no. And you're gonna repeatedly press this button until you get his attention. This is gonna boost him. So he's at 20 right now with a normal correction. If I press this red S button, it's gonna bump him up to 40. This doubles Sterling's level to make it easier for us to get his attention, especially if it were an emergency situation. So that is the boost feature. Again, that's the red S button, and that's for emergencies only. On the other side of the remote, there's a black T button. This is the vibrate feature. So if I press the black T button, you'll hear it on the box. That is the vibrate feature. I have not used this with Sterling, but it can eventually be used as a warning. So if he does something and it's not really worthy of a correction, but you still want to let him know, hey, don't be doing that, you can press the black T button and kind of give him a warning before you give him that correction to see if he's going to need a correction or not. So that is the black T button. Then on the back of the remote, there is that black L button. If I press that instead of hold it, if I press it once, it's going to start flashing a light on the collar. If I press it a second time, it's going to shine the light constantly. And then if I press it again, it's going to shut that light off. So again, press that, it turns the flashlight off. And then again, if I press and hold that button, that's what turns the remote off. Next to that black L button is a smaller M/C button. That changes his collar from momentary to continuous. He's on momentary right now, and there's no reason for him to go back to continuous, so you shouldn't need to mess with that button at all. So that is the M/C button. Now, Sterling is at level 20 right now. If you needed to change that, say you get home and 20 is too much, it's too high of a level, and you feel like that's just way too much for him, then you can turn it down. If 20 isn't enough and you feel like, oh, he's back home, he's trying to push my limits, get away with stuff, or you're out in public and you don't feel like 20 is working for him, you're gonna press and hold this dial until it flashes. Now I can change what his level's at. So if he gets home and 20 is too much, you can bump him down to 15. If 15 isn't enough, you can put him back up to 20. If he gets home and 20 isn't enough for him, you can bump him up to 25. Usually we move the collar up and down by fives. So we're gonna take him back to 20 since that is his current level. And then I'm gonna lock that in place at 20 since that's what I want it to be at. So I'm gonna press and hold that down until the 20 is locked in. Now I can turn this all I want and it's not going to change his level. That feature is there to make sure we don't accidentally bump it and change his level when we're not meaning to. So again, that's how you change his level. And then on the back here, there is this small port. That's the charging port. And there is another one on the collar. So that is where you charge them at. And then the collar is also waterproof. So you want to make sure that if Sterling's going to play in the water, play in the snow, anything like that where he's going to get wet, you want to make sure that those charging ports are fully closed. That way no water gets into the collar. Again, he can wear them when he gets wet, but if he does get wet, you want to make sure to take the collar off, dry him off really well to make sure that he's not going to get any sores from the collar being on when he's wet. So those are the features of the remote. Again, it's waterproof, reaches a half mile, and it usually stays charged for about 2 days, 2 full days. So he can wear the collar 10 to 12 hours a day. And then you want to take it off at night. You can put it on first thing in the morning when you guys get up, and then take it off before you put him in his crate for bed or anything like that. And then we have the box. On the back of the box, there is the place that you can contact to make sure you get your warranty. There's a 2-year warranty that comes with the collars, so you want to make sure to contact them to get your warranty. And then in the box, there are prongs. There's some extra prongs. These ones are just a little bit longer than the ones that are on the collar. Sterling really shouldn't need those because his hair is shorter. But if he ever does, you feel like he's not feeling the collar, anything like that, you can always put the longer prongs on. There are 2 longer prongs, and then there's also a tool to change those with. Then we have the charger. And then we also have the original strap that the collar came with. That's just the, again, the original strap, because we put this one on. That way it has this bungee right here. It can stretch with him, and then it has this quick release snap. So this is what's on the collar right now, but if you wanted to, you could switch it back to the one it came with. Then under this is the instruction manual if you want to go over the collar more in depth. So that's what's in the box. And again, those are the features of the remote. A reminder again, you want to make sure to make sure those ports are fully closed if he's going to get in the snow or the water. And then if he does get in the snow or the water and get wet, you want to make sure to take that collar off of him, dry him really well, maybe wait a few hours, give him a break before putting it back on. That way he doesn't get sores from the collar making contact with his wet skin and hurting him. So again, that is the collar and the features. We want to be sure to have fun with Sterling. He's still a puppy. We want to be sure to reward the things that we like and correct those unwanted behaviors. So it takes about 4 to 6 weeks for our dog to learn behaviors. So Sterling has learned the behaviors, but it's going to take about 4 to 6 months or 500 repetitions for Sterling to really get it locked down in his brain that this is what he's supposed to be doing. So we want to be sure to practice often with him, have lots of fun with him, be rewarding those behaviors to make sure that you build up a reward history so you can fade out the treats eventually. But right now you want to be rewarding him pretty usually. That way he gets used to you using the rewards and he knows, oh, I'm doing what's good, I'm doing what mom wants me to do, anything like that. And then we want to be sure to be firm and consistent with our corrections so Sterling does an unwanted behavior. Again, if he pulls too far ahead of you in a walk, you want to be sure to show him what your expectations are, so correct him when he gets too far ahead of you. Or if he jumps, you want to be sure to correct him for jumping. That way he knows that he's not supposed to be doing that and he's less likely to do it in the future. So again, have fun with Sterling, be firm with your corrections, and then be consistent with him. Make sure he listens all the time, and then make sure that you're giving him rewards when he does those good behaviors and correct the behaviors that you don't like. So again, have fun with him, be firm, be consistent, but mostly have fun with him.